Hey guys, what is going on? Massive Beats checking in here with five very historic and also contemporary bass amps that are being used in studios worldwide as well as on stages. Here we're looking at Universal Audio's emulations of these amps with Unison technology, but except I believe for the world tour, also available plugin Alliance, as they are made by Brainworks, and I'm playing this on a Marcus Miller sort of boutique P10 PJ bass, their latest release, and pickups 50-50, passive mode, everything flat. And yeah, let's start with the Ampeg SVT3 Pro. Let's get going with that, and I circle back each amp twice, so stick around. So the volume is not exactly the same on each amp. It's not a note-by-note comparison, rather a quick, how does it feel to play with these amps? All right, enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, and so here we have it, 25 minutes of playing around and surfing sounds and me, you know, riding the fretboard, trying to see what inspires me the most and how I can connect with these amps so that I can feel their soul, so to speak. Each amp has its own signature. And so I'm trying to kind of find what is it, where is that core? It's kind of like with a bass. You have to feel where it's pulling you. And so this was definitely very interesting for me. So now the SVTR is an amp that I use very, very often. I made one big mistake, and I'm sure you saw this. I had the bass all the way up, which is not that terrible on this amp. Some other amps would just be completely unrealistic after that. But so it has more bass presence than it normally already has. I don't know why I overlooked this. It's probably when you're playing and holding the mouse in one hand. But at any rate, it's an amp because it's a freebie with Universal Audio that I really like. I also own the B15, Ampeg B15N, and I own the Eden, but I don't own the Galion Krüger and the SVT 3 Pro, which I'm considering buying. So this is the amp where I probably lingered around the most. It's intrigued me the most because I don't have it yet. And I feel like it's probably one of the best in there. Now, this is also my, in the studio where I'm practicing, this is also the amp that's there with a 210 box with a tweeter. It's all Ampeg, and it's a great amp. It pushes a lot of air. It just has this heftiness, you know, something that in a live situation you can feel. Now, when you record, when you do this, like, you know, in the box, it's not, you know, you're not going necessarily for that because you're doing this to record, right? You're doing this to put something on tape. So one thing I found out is that the amp that pleases you the most while you're playing might not be the best for that particular track, right? Feels great to have, like, the bass cranked up and to have, like, that, you know, super scooped sound, for example. But this might not be the bass that always sits the best in the track. And I have a feeling that the Galion Krüger, the 800, well, when I played it here, I really didn't like it. It sounds so thin and too many highs and plasticky. But, you know, there's a lot of low end in there as well, and it probably sits pretty well in the mix because it's got enough top end that you can always filter out, but it is there. It's there in the signal. So anyway, so I would say the B15, that's a vintage 60s sound with a good amount of distortion. You can use it on newer stuff too, like rock and metal. It'll sound really great. It has those creamy distorted mids. But anything else, you know, that vintage sound that, you know, late 60s rock, early 70s rock, it gives you that, you know, it sits well. It's definitely a unique character. The Eden, to me, wonderful studio amp. Think Marcus Miller, perhaps, in that sound direction. Everything's crystal clear. It's an amp that just gives you, you know, it's a nice improvement over DI or DI box. It gives you warmer, tighter, yet, you know, doesn't have this strong character that you later on you can't get rid of. So it's a very useful amp. And then, like I said, the SVT 3 Pro, that is an amp, but it has that scooped sound, that heavy low end, and then the top end is not overly pronounced. I like that. It's almost a bit compressed. So when you slap, it doesn't stick out so much. So that's my thought. And then, like I said, the SVTR, the classic version, has limited controls. Well, that is just a great amp that works on anything. It's just round. It's warm. I highly recommend it. Maybe get the Pro version of it. That's not free. But yeah, so those are my thoughts on these amps. Each amp, you have to kind of tweak it a little bit to the sound that you want. The presets is what somebody had in mind at the moment of playing. They had a different bass at hand. So you have to adjust certain things to get the tone right. I encourage you to do that. As you know, you can try these amps on Universal Audio's website, but you can also try them on Plugin Alliance and see how they work for you. It's also a good idea to record, you know, with DI and then later on decide in the track. I like to commit very early because it really influences my playing. If it's a fast amp that reacts and has all the pops, then I play a bit more aggressive. And if it's something that's slow and thick and hefty, well, then I'm going to lean more back and play it probably at a different position on the fretboard as well. And I pick differently and I use a different hand position, because the fingers, the body that, you know, your body is going to adjust, it's going to react, it's going to work with the amp and the instrument. I know that from playing live. And so go ahead, try them out and see how you feel and let me know. But how does it sound when we use them in the mix? That's a whole other video, but I'm sure some of you have used them and so might say like, well, you know what? That Galleon Krüger sits just perfectly. Doesn't sound that beautiful by itself, but in the mix, that's what I'm using. So can't wait to hear from you. All right, thanks for checking in. Beats out.
Really?